As part of an 8-year-old restoration project, scientists, community members, and tribes are trying to restore forests in the Jemez Mountains to what they were like before widespread grazing and then fire suppression. They're also learning about how the forest, its wildlife, and its waterways recover after fire. It starts with knowing what a healthy forest looks like. Laura Pascas takes us there this month for our latest installment in the series, Our Land, New Mexico's Environmental Past, Present, and Future.
This is the History Grove, which is one of the few places on the preserve that did not get logged in the 1960s and 70s. It shows a very typical forest structure of what southwestern forests would have looked like prior to human occupation.
Bob Parmenter and other scientists use the History Grove in the Valles Caldera National Preserve to show students and visitors what a healthy forest should look like in northern New Mexico.
Probably a very open, grassy understory, only a few logs on the ground and no branches coming down to the ground. And that's because we had fires coming through here all the time. Every 4 or 5 years, a low intensity fire would burn through, kill the young trees, burn up the stumps and the logs, burn up the needles.
But most of the forest around the Valles Caldera isn't healthy. Fire suppression was the priority for decades and led to an overgrowth of trees. And that created dangerous conditions for fast, hot wildfires like the Cerro Grande in 2000 and Las Conchas in 2011.
A lot of our forests today are what we refer to as dog hair thickets. That is, the young trees are there as thick as the hair on the back of a dog. And what we need to do before we can get natural fire involved there is to thin those forests out, remove as much fuel as we can, get them down to about 100 trees per acre. This is 40 trees per acre. So if we can reduce it down from 500 or 1,000 trees per acre to 100, then we can start getting natural fires back in the system.
For almost a decade, two programs have brought together tribes, scientists, land managers, environmentalists, and the timber industry to plan how to manage the forest to make it healthier. Stakeholders are working on more than 200,000 acres.
The really great thing about our collaborative here is it involves everybody, multiple agencies that have jurisdiction over land units. It involves universities, it involves environmental groups, it involves forest industry groups. So it's everybody that used to view each other across the tables in a courtroom are now sitting down together and all recognizing the problem and working together to develop the plans to restore these forests. So far in our 8 years of operation here, we haven't spent a single nickel on lawyers. And so it's been all devoted to operations on the ground to really help the forests recover.
This summer, the Cajete fire started from a campfire in the Jemez Mountains. Knowing that conditions could be ripe for another bad fire, firefighters acted fast. It burned about 1,400 acres, including an area managers had already marked for restoration. Susan Harrelson plays a role in this aspect of the collaboration.
And so I make decisions about whether a stand of trees needs to be cut or not, and if so, how should it be cut, which trees should remain, and which ones should be cut. This is an uneven age stand, meaning that there's large trees, medium trees, and small trees, and that's good. When you have an uneven age stand, it can maintain itself over time. But there were just too many trees in here, so we were going to thin it out, but still leave some large trees, some medium-sized trees, and some saplings, and make some openings in here so that the light could get to the ground, so that the snow could get to the ground and melt into the ground, so that there'd be more grass and flowers growing on the forest floor.
The collaborative program started before the Las Conchas fire. That means they're able to study the impacts of devastating fires as well as the healthy, low-intensity kind of fires that are a natural part of a southwestern forest. They're paying close attention to how trees respond.
We're starting to get monsoons already, so some of these trees might be able to pull through if they get enough rain. Even though all the needles are scorched, if they get enough moisture, they can put out a fresh batch of needles and possibly pull through. We'll just have to see what happens next.
Forest management is costly, and seeing the benefits of forest restoration projects can take years, but it's paying off.
The research program that has been monitoring all of these different aspects of the restoration program have shown fairly convincingly that the restoration projects are having the desired effects. We are seeing reduction in fuel loads. We are seeing increase in grasses and forbs. We are seeing greater areas with snowpack. So a lot of the predictions from this have been shown to be true.